welcome to this edition of DTV News. It's May 17th, 2005.
I'm Emily Burwell alongside Jamie Shipley. So sit back and relax. Your DTV News starts right now.
This is your DTV News Live, bringing you your news, sports, and student life.
Story, drinking and driving is a deadly combination. A recent accident in neighboring Lapeer County proved deadly for some teenagers. DTV's got the inside scoop. On April 1st, 2005, in Lapeer County, two automobile accidents resulted in 9 deaths. In Oregon Township, a drinking and driving accident resulted in 4 deaths and 2 critical injuries, leaving one county in mourning.
Monica Diaz, a student at DHS, was close to several of the victims in the crash.
Drinking and driving can be prevented. You just have to be strong enough to not let your friends drink and drive, or you have to be strong enough to not drink and drive and be able to say no to drinking and make the smarter choice at not affecting your friends and the other people around you who love you. Life can be gone in an instant. 15 minutes later, they were gone. I was with them, and 15 minutes later, he was gone.
Drinking and driving contributed to 124 fatal crashes, 370 serious injury crashes, and 859 minor injury crashes.
31% of all road deaths were in drinking-related crashes.
Drunk drivers were responsible for killing 38 of their own passengers, 26 other driver passengers, pedestrians, and 77 of these drunk drivers were themselves killed.
Drinking and driving has impacted my life greatly. I had a friend about a month ago who was drinking and driving and got killed.
So think of the choices before you drink and drive, or you could end up here.
Emily Burwell,
Jamie Shipley, DTV News.
Thanks, guys. Obesity is a serious problem for today's teens. Southwestern's Ashley examines the alarming problem.
Obesity is on the rise among high school students, and many prefer fast food over their everyday cafeteria lunch. Nearby fast food restaurants, such as McDonald's, often offer a better variety of foods for a cheaper price. McDonald's new dollar menu includes the double cheeseburger and McChicken sandwiches, which are popular among teens. So why are so many students trading in their lunch trays for paper bags filled with fat and grease?
It's like a trend, or it's like the thing to go out and eat, you know, buy something, fast food, because, you know, it kind of shows that you got a car, you got a ride, you got some money to go out to get something to eat.
We've gotten down to why students migrate to fast food joints during lunch, but how often are they doing this?
Probably about 3 times.
3 times a weekend. Where do you usually go?
Burger King, McDonald's.
What is
fried chicken?
With teen obesity rates tripling since 1980, America seems to have become the land of the free, home of the big. Ashley Arter, Southwestern Academy.
Thank you, Ashley. On a lighter note, summer is almost here, and it's time to break out the tank tops and shorts. Lake Fenton's Jackie Gibson tells us how students are spending the next few months.
It's just about that time of year for final exams, graduation, and the excitement of summer break. So what are kids planning for this summer? Let's take a look.
Do you have any exciting plans for the summer?
Well, I'm getting ready for my open house at the end of June. And then in July, I'm just going to hang out with friends and chill on the lake. And in August, I'm going to Europe with my family.
Do you have family in Europe?
Yes, they live in Hungary.
Are you from Hungary?
No, but my dad is.
Going on the lake? Going to Cedar Point? Fans Warped Tour?
Any other big plans? Trips?
tailgating at Vans Warped Tour?
A summer planning to relax and go out on the lake and attend concerts. Others are conditioning for college sports, like Ricky, a senior from Hamity, who is going to play football.
I'm doing that in the summer. Well, let's see, work, play lift weights, get ready for college football.
Anything else?
No.
Where are you playing football at?
I'm not sure either, like Ferris, Northwood, or Eastern.
So whether you're leaving the country, going out on the lake, or conditioning for the upcoming college football team, have a fun and safe summer, because I know I will. This is Jackie Gibson reporting to you from Lake Fenton High School.
Chewing gum for some people is a true art form. Although popping bubbles and smacking in tune can keep some people focused to others, it's simply annoying. Monica Thomas introduces us to one Southwestern teacher who has the market and cornered on chewing gum in his school.
Hey, what's that sound? Is it a bird?
Or is it a bunch of killer crickets coming to plague the earth? No, 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 you students of Michigan, America, or wherever the heck you're from. It's just Mr. Jackson chewing his gum. So what kind of effect does longtime coach and teacher James Jackson, a.k.a. Jimmy Jack, give to his peers, students, and athletes while he uniquely chews his gum? And how does he do it? How are you affiliated with Jimmy Jack?
Yes, I've been running for about 4 years for him.
What kind of gum does he chew?
Sugar-free. He used to chew like double mint, but he said he chews sugar-free now because it was bad for his teeth.
Tried it.
What does he sound like when he chews his gum?
It's.
Well, we may not have solved the mystery of how Mr. Jackson chews his gum, but we sure have found that Jimmy Jack has a trademark, and the legacy of his gum chewing will forever prevail.
Thanks, Monica. Now let's head over to Ashley with your DTV Sports.
Thanks, guys. Many kids grow up admiring and imitating professional basketball players. And the scary part is that they start to believe that they can play with the big boys. The odds of making it in the NBA are not good. Our own R.C. Kennard explores this topic.
This is Flint, where basketball is almost a religion, where kids dream of being the next Mateen Cleaves or the next Morris Peterson. They change high schools like they change socks in search of the best team to play on. At Southwestern Academy this year, 3 of the 5 starters had transferred in from other schools.
Well, it's a game, so it comes easy for them.
Varsity coach Jeff Whiteley explains why basketball is such an obsession and what can happen when academics are neglected.
A lot of them see basketball as an easy way out of, instead of going through the process of going to college and finding a job, and you know that's hard work, and a lot of kids think that basketball is just an easier way for them. A lot of them don't make other plans though. That's why they struggle just at getting eligible to play high school basketball. Their chances of making it to the pros are bad. Chances of getting into college are hard enough, but if you don't have any grades, you're not going to make it there either. So,
Principal Ginsburg, a former basketball coach himself, gave his views on the importance of an education.
I believe in balance. I mean, I believe that all young people, all adults, all young people should strive to have a balanced life between family, religion, if that's important to them, certainly academics, and athletics if they're so inclined. If you're putting more time into athletics than you are into your education, that's a formula for failure. If you have an education, you can do anything you want basically in this world.
If these students don't start paying more attention to their academics, then our economy is in for a heck of a shock because there are not enough fast food jobs to go around.
That's all we have for our sports today. Back to you guys with the rest of our news.
Most parents put a lot of thought into their child's name, but others don't. It would seem like the best idea because a child's name can greatly affect the way they see themselves and the way others see them.
My name is Cormisha, and I think it's a real ghetto name.
My name is Corey, and I think my name is boring.
Although some names are given simply because they are cute, some names actually have cultural meaning and can be quite confusing to a stranger.
My name is Juanita Lightfoot, and
a lot of people, basically, they judge me before they see me just based on my name. They think that I'm either Mexican or Latino.
It's a white boy name, and I'm mixed, and I don't think it fits me at all. At all.
A name can set you apart from the crowd, and while some dislike this, like Cormisha, others, like Tavila, don't seem to mind. She sees it as a special distinction all her own.
A lot of people call it ghetto, but I just like it because it's different.
It seems that as you get older, the more you get used to your name, and you even learn to love it. Adults are a lot more content and accepting of their names.
You get over it, and then you just learn to accept your name, and you learn to live with it.
And on the one hand, your name could be positive, and on the other hand, it could be negative. It just depends on what your perception is about it.
Even still, you can always dream.
I want some off-the-wall stuff, like some Taekwondo or something, some D'Angelo.
Art is just art for some people, but for others, it is a way to be remembered. Lauren Trakel has more.
Art class in high school. You have your everyday projects that are hung up for a little while and then taken down after a couple of weeks. For two independent art students, Jay Nellens and Krista Miner, they are creating a piece of art that will stay in the lobby of Goodrich High School for quite some time. Their new project is the Door Project.
The Door Project is an opportunity for the leaders of tomorrow to express their opinion about major issues and how they might solve those issues. It began about 5 years ago at a high school on the western side of Michigan, and it now has spread across the United States. At Goodrich High School, it is my dream that I will have enough doors someday that an entire class can express themselves.
For the past couple of weeks, senior Jay Nellens has put hours of priming, sketching, and painting into her new project.
I saw a bunch of facts that were appalling about world hunger, and I decided that I would draw about it because it was really bad, because there's so many people in the world that there's enough food for, but they're dying. Well, I wanted to draw like a really long buffet table that showed like infinite amounts of people. So I made it kind of fade into the distance. And I made them look really skinny because they're starving. And I wanted to put empty plates in front of them with facts on the plates instead of food to kind of get people to look and read and learn. And at the end of the table, they kind of float off into space, which is like their death because they're not getting any help. And I hope it'll look good.
With every problem, there needs to be a solution, and it just so happens there can be a solution to the subject of world hunger.
On my side of the door, I have to solve the world issue of hunger. Like, love doesn't solve the problem, but because of love, we help each other out.
That's all we have today for your DTV News.
From myself, Jamie, and the rest of the DTV crew, have a great day.